It's AumSum time!
Why are clouds white? Simple.
Because I paint them every day.
Oh, AumSum. Sunlight or white light is a combination of all visible colors of light. Each color has a different wavelength. Red light has the longest wavelength. Now, small atmospheric particles that exist in the sky scatter shorter wavelengths more efficiently. Hence, the sky appears blue. But, in the case of a cloud, the water droplets present in them are much bigger. They scatter all the wavelengths of light approximately with the same effectiveness. These scattered wavelengths interact and combine to again generate white color. Hence, the cloud appears white. Then why do clouds sometimes appear gray? This is because the scattered light in the cloud is usually sent upwards or to the sides, thus making them appear more white as compared to the lower portion, which receives less light.
To buy AumSum merchandise, visit AumSum.com.
Topic: heat transfer. Why are cloudy nights warmer than clear nights? Hey, look at the weather outside. It is too cloudy. No, don't go near that bonfire. It is going to be warm tonight. You don't want to listen to me, right? All right, go ahead. Look, I told you. At least now will you listen to me? During the day, our Earth receives light from the sun and gets heated. Now, during a clear night, that is, when there are no clouds, this heat easily escapes through the atmosphere into space, resulting in cooling of the Earth. Now, to understand what happens on a cloudy night, let us heat the Earth once again. In this case, the clouds act like a blanket, preventing the heat from escaping into space. Since the heat remains in the atmosphere, cloudy nights are warmer than clear nights. What if Sahara Desert is covered with solar panels?
No! Let's cover it with pizzas and burgers!
Oh, listen. The Sahara Desert is around 9.2 million square kilometers in area. Based on this, it can be estimated that the total energy produced by the solar panels would be approximately 22 billion gigawatt hours per year. This would be thousands of times our current electricity requirement. Secondly, while generating electricity, fossil fuel power plants produce harmful gases and nuclear power plants produce radioactive waste. But solar panels produce electricity without causing harm to the environment. Now, let's have a look at some minor disadvantages. Firstly, sandstorms in the desert would regularly cover the solar panels with sand, thus reducing their efficiency. Secondly, in a place where water is so scarce, cleaning the panels would definitely be challenging. Lastly, the project would prove to be extremely costly, but looking at the advantages, the cost seems to be worth it.